Hello, I'm Ellie for Edu for Java, and today we are going to see data entry and data printing through the Java console. We had already seen the printing of data through the console, if you remember. Data entry is a bit more complicated, but our tutorials are going to be more fun when we learn to do it. First thing of all, new Java project. Let's create a project called Tutorials. We're going to create a new package. Packages are to organize Java classes. As I'm going to use this package to keep several tutorials, I'm going to do it to organize myself. Java to keep you to help you organize classes. Classes go into a file, usually uses packages. These packages keep these files. In this case, we're going to use a package called tutorial4.edu4java.com. Here we can see another characteristic. Packages are normally defined with a lower case and with words separated with a dot. Usually, you use a domain. Here I'm using a domain, edu4java.com, to create a unique identifier of the package. Later on, we will take another look to packages. Finish. Here we have a package. Now we create a class. Tutorial 4. Finish. As we can see, there is something new. This declaration package. In the same file of the Java class, it tells us in which package it is. When I created this class, I forgot to create the main method. As you remember, it is the method which defines the initiation of the execution. A class can only be run if it has a method main and static. If you write main and you press control space, Eclipse offers me to create the method main automatically. Public static main. Eclipse generates everything for me. This is all at the same height. To understand it better, we usually format the code. If we format the code, we can see what is inside what. This method, which is inside this class, should be in another line. If we press Ctrl Shift F, Eclipse is going to format the code. Until now, we had seen that CISO control space allowed us to print on the console. Run as Java application. As you can see, Edu is written on the console. This would be the printing of the data. We are sending data from our program to the console. What we need to make this more interesting is to feed the program with data. Java has a class called Scanner, which allows us to create an object which reads from the console and delivers the data to the program using a method called next. Let's see how it works. We have to declare a type scanner variable. Here we have something new. New scanner. System.in. Here we have a creation of an object. This is the new thing. This definition of a variable was what we saw in the past tutorials, but this variable has something special. The type of this variable, scanner, see that the variables are written by convention with lowercase and the classes by convention with uppercase. This variable scanner belongs to the class scanner with uppercase. With this new, what we do is create an instance of the object scanner. And we're going to save it in the variable scanner. To create this instance of the object scanner, we are asking the class scanner to give us a new instance, a new object of scanner. Classes are like modes from which we can create a new object with this mode. Scanner is the class, and when we write new scanner, what we obtain is going to be an object which belongs to the scanner. This is not a tutorial really about objects. So I recommend you to go to the part of objects in Edu for Java if you feel a bit lost. But anyway, I'm talking a little bit about objects to make you feel familiar. When we create scanner, we pass him an argument. We are telling him what to scanner. We want him to scanner system.in. System.in is going to be the console. It will scanner this. As before, we said print system.out, print line, and it was printed here. In this case, it is system.in. It is in because from here we're going to get data. You don't really have to understand it, just so that you get familiar with the concept. We'll see it again in the part of objects. I can ask the scanner to give me the next one. It has a method which gives me the next. The next what? You will be asking. The next data entry. We are going to call it entrada, entry. What I'm trying to do here is to assign a variable entrada, what it's read through the scanner. Here I have an error, as you can see. Here we have a variable which is not defined yet. Here we have another variable which is already defined, scanner. I ask for help, create local variable entrada, and automatically it helps me out and writes the variable type. And here we have the creation of the variable and the assignment. Now, I have the object scanner. I ask this object scanner to give me the next data entry, and I'm going to keep it in this variable. And next I'm going to put the variable. Let's see what happens. We run it and apparently nothing happens. What happened is it ran this line. It created the scanner object. And here scanner.next was executed. This method is waiting for me to write something on the console. When I write edu on the console, for example, automatically goes to the next instruction. And when I press return, this ends and it is inserting the entire variable, edu, and edu is going to be printed with system.out entrada entry. The first one was written by me and the second edu was written by entrada. Maybe you can see it more clearly if I write more comments. Let's write before it asks for entrada. Let's write CISO console space. Let's write scanear, scanner, for example. And after the scanner finishes, let's write CISO console space and show the word scanner, mostrar escaneado, show scanner data. Let's run this. And here again, scanner was created. It got here and it printed scanner. It got to this method and this method stopped the execution. It is waiting for us to write something on the console. Edu for Java. Return. It continues to the next line. Show the scanner data, mostrar lo escaneado, and afterwards we write the entrada content. This is the variable entrada was filled with what the object scanner read from the console. And here it is printed. With this, which is a bit complicated because I'm already talking about objects, the creation of objects with parameters. I'm talking about methods. The object scanner has a method next which returns a string. It is a bit complicated, but I wanted to do this so that we could work with scanner so that tutorials can be more interesting. With this, our program can enter data to our program and it is going to be more interesting. This is all for this tutorial. See you in the next one.